All right, hello there, and welcome to a tutorial on the NINJATRADER platform. One of the few things you can do once you've gotten a, say, Apex or Leeloo account is they provide you with NINJATRADER license. I've already signed it in for myself. But I think it's self-explanatory. When you install a program, it'll ask you for a license key at the beginning. What you might want to use the NINJATRADER platform is that when you have a chart up, we can put it down to 1 minute, is that you could plot, say, your executions on a chart. Helps you to review at the end of the day, to bring up that feature in the chart. You'd go into the data series, and usually by default it tends to already be active. It comes down to this section about trades. Because the market is closed, any trades that he probably won't show up. But what we can do is use the NINJATRADER simulate data feed. And if you take a trade within, going to the chart trader,
order submitted. Order canceled.
NINJATRADER also has its own sort of DOM, which is under the Super DOM static. Select our trading instruments. And you can place your trades within this bid side and your X side.
Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order filled. Order filled. Order submitted. Order filled. Order filled.
And just like that, it tends to show you within the bar where your trades had been executed. Might even better to even have it down into a seconds of charts to see how crazy this would have been. It's just the constant trades that could have been taken. Because we've spoken before on the Jigsaw platform, when you install Jigsaw the first time, there would be an option to check the NINJATRADER 8 indicator, the included is in. You can go through down into your studies, it's the section up here, or on your chart you can right click, add indicators. Scroll down till you find the JT connection. You can place it on your chart. This will automatically open up my Jigsaw Trader. Jigsaw Daytrader platform, and I can open up a depth in sales using it as the data feed. Normally you'd be connecting through here, but you want to go into platform, and that gives you the connection of your NT8. Okay. This could be a good time as any to compare the platforms. There's more features involved within the Jigsaw platform compared to the NINJATRADER 8 platform, as well as the fact of how it can scale. But any orders placed within Jigsaw will show up within your NT8 as well. Let's go into market.
Order filled.
You see on this side, I went into market and it is within your Jigsaw and NT8 DOMs. Let's take that loss.
Order filled.
Another feature, of course, within the Jigsaw platform connected to the NT8 is the fact that you can keep track within how well you're performing. And Ninja also has their trade performance. So for these trades we were taking, I netted a $25 loss. Commissions can be shown, but though this is a simulated data feed, it does not have them. We can check our max drawdowns prior to obtaining any sorts of profits that ended us with our net, as well as seeing the amount of trades, our percent profitability, and how it goes into winning or losing trades. Long trades seem to have been the trades it took most often, short trades not as often, but they tend to have won us more in this situation. You can set through and have it so that on a charts when you place your orders.
Order submitted. Order submitted.
You can also scroll them around within NINJATRADER. And they'll appear within your Jigsaw DOM as well.
Order filled.
If the setup works for you, and it's something you want to keep for any time that you open the platform back up, make sure that you save the workspace so that when you close it, and ask it as well, again, if you'd like to save this, the next time you open up the platform, it should all come back. To create your data feed for when the market are open, you can go into your connections to configure. Scroll down to find Rhythmic that you can add in and put in your username and password provided to you by either any of the evaluations or for your own accounts. If you're using evaluation, make sure that you choose the Rhythmic paper trading, dependent on the location closest to you, or Rhythmic O1s, depending on the locations closest to you. In this instance, I did set off an Apex feed that I set to Rhythmic Paper Trading in Chicago. some features of NINJATRADER that make it very useful is the Atm strategies you can find within Ninja. You can create one by going to custom with inside your chart trader. We'll say a quantity of 2. And let's have it so that we have 2 targets, 1 lot each, a stop loss of 3 ticks. First profit could be 2 and 4 ticks. Save it as our template, and we'll call it our test. Doing it this way, when I place an order,
order filled,
has it so that I have target my 3-tick stop, my 1-tick, 2-tick profit, and a 4-tick profit. It'll appear also within Jigsaw and can be dragged around using the features of both.
Target filled.
They'll also automatically cancel out. Some more interesting ways of using Ninja is you can create more custom stop strategies. If you had runners, for say, you could set it so that your second lot, once you were in a profit of already 2 ticks, we could set it to break even automatically. Okay. We'll test that again.
Order filled. Stop filled. Order filled. Target filled.
Our break even came down automatically, so that this trade would have became filled. No loss and some gain. Both Ninja and Jigsaw are able to connect more than one data feed. And so in this instance, if say I had my data feed from our earlier test, and I could use that, say if this was more accurate, we could have our ES going while our replay feed. We'll say this was the 3rd at 9 o'clock. If this was more of an accurate feed for us, you'd be able to choose within this for NINJATRADER trades, but you'd be able to watch the data feed on your trade of 8 feed using CQG. If, for instance, you find that quicker than rhythmics provided by Leeloo or Apex. Let's disconnect that to continue on. Something as well that makes easier within the NINJATRADER platform are the use of drawing tools. These tools tend to be pretty quick and easy to use for marking out areas of support and resistance, or when you want to be trading a range. I tend to just use the horizontal line, as most other lines don't tend to help with how I view the market. I think those would be one of the main pros involved Ninja is just the ATM strategies, the drawing tools, and the fact of having the use case of the connection between Jigsaw and Ninja. I do find that as far as cons go, the Ninja order flow tools that they tend to have are subpar. You tend to need to buy third-party indicators. In this case, Jigsaw is a third-party indicator because it beats out the DOM that is provided within Ninja. It's usable, but not perfect. I think this wraps up for this basic tutorial of NINJATRADER and Jigsaw. You might ask, of course, why would you even connect them that way? I like to see the executions within the chart so that you can have a nice debrief. All right. Please like, subscribe, comment, share with friends. And we'll provide another video of you guys next time. Thank you.